2 years before Jared Dutoit enjoyed a magical run as an amateur at the RBC Canadian Open at Glen Abbey, Taylor Pendrith, like Dutoit, a member of Golf Canada's national amateur team at the time, turned heads at the Open at Royal Montreal, blasting his way onto the first page of the leaderboard with an opening round 65.
There's some courses that suit my game really well because, you know, I can hit it pretty far off the tee with the driver, and this course sets up great for me. On some of the holes on the front, you know, I can just hit driver as hard as I can.
Though he went backwards on day two, Pendrith posted weekend rounds of 68-69 to finish tied for 43rd in his first taste of PGA Tour action. More impressively, he led the field in distance off the tee, pounding out dozens of drives well over 300 yards. If power has become the most important attribute on today's PGA Tour, Pendrith proved he had it in spades, and he seemed set for success. But nothing in golf is guaranteed. And while Pendrith secured Web.com Tour status shortly after turning professional, a string of injuries since 2016 have stalled his ascension. First, it was a torn ligament in his wrist, the same ailment that felled Brooks Koepka before he returned and defended his US Open title this year. Then a muscle tear in Pendrith's palm, and then a torn tendon in his elbow. There were multiple MRIs, long stretches of physio, and prescribed rest. But in the dog-eat-dog world of professional golf, Pendrith tried to play through the pain for fear of falling behind. That was a mistake, and the only thing he had to show for his perseverance was a pile of missed cuts and a loss of playing privileges.
I wouldn't say it took my power away, but it definitely affected my ball flight, where I was hitting it. I was hitting it everywhere. I was hitting it the highest I've ever hit it. I don't really hit it that high, and I was just trying to save it. I was scared to kind of hit the ground and take a divot. I was picking it and hitting it straight up in the air. But, I mean, extremely frustrating. Obviously, I wanted to play in every event that I could, and it's been kind of a weird 2 years, I'd say, for me, but it's all good now.
Having smartened up and shut it down, Pendrith returned to competition this spring finally healthy. He went to Mackenzie Tour PGA Tour Canada Q School to gain some status on the domestic circuit and earned a full slate of starts thanks to a tie for fourth in July at the Windsor Championship, a new claw putting grip boosting his confidence on the greens. More than anything though, Pendrith knows patience will be paramount after he essentially had to start over. In the meantime, he's been inspired by the play of his good pals and fellow Kent State University alumni, Mackenzie Hughes and Corey Connors, who have already hoisted or hunted for PGA Tour trophies.
Just seeing that those guys, you know, their successes, and I played 4 years with Corey and 2 years with Mac, and we've been through the Golf Canada program, and you know, I think if I keep practicing and playing that the way I'm capable of, that hopefully I can get there one day too and be out with them, because it'd be pretty fun to be out there together.